Our message to the entire Baltimore region, especially those selling drugs and pulling triggers, is this. These cases are just the beginning for the Baltimore Strike Force. There are more investigations in the pipeline, and we will not rest until our neighborhoods are safe.
And the reality is that the government does move slow. We all know that. This has been in planning for about 2.5-3 years. So we know that this is now starting to matriculate and it's starting to move to some water action.
And that is U.S. Attorney for Maryland Robert Herr and Baltimore City State Senator Corey McCray on WBAL News Now with Brian Niemann. They were talking about the strike force, the combining of 18 different state, federal, and local agencies into one unit. They will have an office in Montgomery Park, Baltimore County Council approving the funding for this. C4, we've been talking a lot about this.
Yes.
A lot of it is what we've heard before, but it's an expansion of what we've heard before.
A big expansion. And what I go to is the fact that not only are we including the law enforcement, you know, Anne Arundel County Police, Baltimore County Police,
sure,
Baltimore City Police, we're including the U.S. Postal Office to go after the fentanyl that's being mailed in that is combining with the issue of overdoses.
The Secret Service on
counterfeiting. The Secret Service going after the money. We're looking at Mexican, Dominican Republic cartels and going after the... So they're really... It appears to me to be a very comprehensive, all-encompassing approach to gangs, to really targeting gangs in this area.
The response has been largely positive, but there's still some skepticism that
earned.
Will really
well earned. Yeah. I mean, we went through the era of BFED, War Room. You can
right.
use all the different names we've had of different acronyms of federal, state, local partnerships. That proof will be in the pudding, Robert, but I'm already seeing, at least in what was presented yesterday, I can see the vision of somebody being arrested, going through the federal system, doing federal time, and that message being sent all across the city.
Robert Herr is appearing in public service messages that are airing on WBAL and other stations around the city. We're reminding people, don't commit gun crimes because you're going to be prosecuted at the federal level and you're going to go to places like Leavenworth and there's no time off for good behavior.
And your family have to catch a plane to visit you.
Right.
I mean, the message I think is important, Robert, is the criminals in the city, according to Commissioner Michael Harrison, he said this, the criminals in Baltimore City do not fear the outcome of the criminal justice system. What Robert Herr and the group yesterday are trying to do is make them fear the outcome, fear what happens to you once you get arrested.
Administering the federal money for this will be Baltimore County. Baltimore
yep.
County will be the fiduciary for this. That's they administer the grant money, not Baltimore City.
That's a big deal.
Not City Hall. That is a big deal.
It shows you, I believe, the lack of trust and faith that the federal government has, at least at this juncture, because the money is coming from the feds into
sure.
whatever jurisdiction, of handling the money well. And I think Baltimore City and to be honest, I'm a city resident, we have earned that cynicism, that we could handle this appropriately. So Baltimore County, as you said, will handle it.
If I'm Mayor Jack Young or Council President Scott or any other member of the city council or city government, should I feel insulted?
No, I think you should go look in the mirror and figure out why they did this. And if you go look in the mirror and try to change the ways that we operate from a fiduciary standpoint, then the next time we have a go-round, the federal government will do it. Give an example, Robert.
Sure.
We have just now, I think, paid for the insurance for the ransomware that we
right.
needed $6
million.
To pay for.
$6 million, thank you very much.
But the thing is, why wasn't that done, like before we just had the ransomware
right.
attack, why did it take so long to get the insurance in place to prevent the next ransomware? That's just one example, I believe, of fiduciary, let's just say, issues.
It sounds like this is also coming from, you know, President Trump's criticism of Congressman Cummings, you know, and then people were asking, you know, where is the billions of dollars going?
Well, if that was the case, why would they give it to Democratic County, Baltimore County? I mean,
sure.
they gave it to, give it to Hartford, that's where a Republican
right.
is.
Right.
If it was simply based on the political calculus, I think it would have gone to a Republican jurisdiction and not a Democratic one, as Baltimore County is.
All right. C4 show is back tomorrow, 9
Thank you,
to
Robert.
1 on WBAL, News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.